afro music, you know what I'm talking about? I need that type. You're doing okay. How's everybody doing tonight, right?
Yeah.
Bueno. Most of you know me. My name is Rodrigo. Do you know where I am from?
Puerto Rico!
That's right. Thank you. That's my clientes right there talking to you. They know me very well. Well, I'm here because I have... Wait a minute. What are you doing here?
There is a party going on here tonight.
It's me, hermano. It's Juan. Hey, Juan, ¿qué pasa, muchacha? Hey, why don't you get yourself a microphone? No one can hear you.
I cannot believe you are here.
I can't believe you are here, man. What are you doing here? What are you doing at Portadown?
You know, it's amazing. I don't know. I kind of have a special interest here.
You have a special interest here? I must say, I'm happy to see you, but I am so happy to see you too.
I did not expect, you know, we
I spend my time south of the equator, you spend your time north of the equator.
Exactly, but I think we are north of the equator.
So, I mean, I'm glad to see you, but so tell me a little bit. So what are you here for?
Well, I have to tell you what happened. There was a girl that came down from the north to visit the south, and I find her there. And I come to see her here. Imagine that, she's in this room. Crossing enemy lines, huh?
That's okay. Where is she? Come on, where is this girl?
I hate to admit it.
Who is the unlucky, lucky girl? You made the second best choice. Where is she?
She is sitting behind us. Her name is Shani.
Shani? Oh, no, you're talking about her mother. She is very fair.
No, Frederico. I'm talking about Shani right there. This beautiful desert flower.
I know her. Shani.
What do you mean?
Shame on you. Shamey is mine. And I don't even care who she's sitting here with. Who is this clown?
I do not know this clown, but it does not
circus. She's a circus freak or something. There's small children here, you know.
I'm telling you.
Okay, let me tell you why I am here. Then you can explain yourself, okay? I am here because I have a very specialized intelligence operation that manages my ladies, okay? I know the comings and the goings and where they are going whenever I want them to know them, okay? I found out I got a little piece of mail that was saying that Shani was going to marry some guy. So I just came here to say hello and wish her hello, because I know this isn't going to last.
It would have been a joke. I thought the same thing.
I was just coming to congratulate her on giving it a shot, you know? Nothing's going to change between Shani and I, but now that you show up on the scene, I screw it up.
I thought the same thing. I knew nothing could be real between the two of them because it was so real between us.
Juanito, I never thought this would happen where another woman comes between us.
I never thought that either.
You know, I think what's most concerning to me is that, you know, every night she's walks right in my face. Since I met her from the start, I'm so proud that she's my only one, and that she wants me so bad. One thing I know is that our girl is mine.
She's not yours.
No, not yours. She's mine. No, not yours.
It could not be true.
I think it is, man. You're going to find out.
Well, what I came here to tell you is, I don't understand the way you think, saying that she's yours, not mine. Sending roses, piñatas, and other things is just a waste of time, because she's mine.
This is crap.
The doggone girl is mine, but she's not. Don't waste your time. The doggone is mine.
You know, John, on the next verse.
They get it anywhere,
but I love her endlessly.
Love it, we won't share.
So why don't we go and go with me right now? The one thing is clear is that us, we both cannot have her, and it's one or the other.
This girl is mine. driving is getting good.
I tell you something. I have to explain. Let me explain, and I'll tell you all why she is mine. Something happened.
Let's hear this.
Something happened south of the equator. I will paint a picture for you. There we were. The sun was setting.
Where was it?
In the distance.
Where?
It does not matter. Puerto Vallarta. The sand was warm on our toes as we were bathing in the setting sun. There was the faint smell of carne asada from a street taco vendor. Oh. There were cold drinks in the sand.
What were you drinking?
Horchata. It was the most perfect moment of my life.
I can't take it.
The most perfect moment. And by my side was Shamey. Shamey was there with me. And at that moment, things could not have been better.
Is this true?
Things could not have been better between the two of us.
Dying.
And I could not stand it any longer. I could not stand it. And all of a sudden, I released this manly cry. I could not hold it in any longer. And it went like this. I could not hold it in.
That's a beautiful manly cry.
But now that we are here, and there's some other clown that's going to marry Shamey, I would like to hear his manly cry.
Yeah. You are brilliant. Hey, Joe mama, stand up, man. Let's hear your tongue on front and center.
Let's hear your manly cry.
And come on out, frente.
Apparently, it's his wedding day. The pinnacle of his life, just like it was for me down there in Puerto Vallarta, and I could not hold
what
it.
What did Shamey say when you let out your manly cry?
I know you love me. Those were her words. I know you love me.
Did she tell you it was a beautiful manly cry?
A beautiful, beautiful manly cry. There we go. Joe, let's hear your manly cry.
We're going to find out, Chivato.
We're going to find out if it's working for her. Why don't you unleash the beast?
Yeah, why don't you pop the cork?
Pull the trigger.
Why don't you crack the whip? Do something. Do something. Quit standing there wasting all of our time.
What we do. Sure. Do some little something like this. This hand here, this hand here.
Yeah. Shamey, what do you think about the manly cry?
I like that.
That's funny, why? Because she said the same thing to me.
What do you mean she said the same thing to you?
You know, we're going to get to the bottom of this. It's not over yet. Joe, sit down. Waste of space.
Okay, you know, that's only half of the equation. I'm glad that there was the manly cry, Juanito. But let me tell you about something that happened with me and Shamey. It was in Cabo San Lucas. I remember because it was that night. The sun was down. He said goodbye. But then the moon rose up and said good morning. Yes, it was very beautiful. And the breeze was so beautiful and nice. Me and Jamie were there on the beach, right where the dance floor is. And the palm trees were waving to us. Hi. Hi. Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Muy bien. Me too. It was so beautiful. I must tell you, it was the most romantic meeting. And there was one moment in the passion of our dancing. We were dancing so close together. It was so beautiful. She said, stop. Rodrigo, stop. I know what you said. But I had not said nothing. I was trying to communicate with her through my dance. I said to Shamey, what did I tell you? With my hips. She said, I love you. Take me. That is exactly what I had said with my hips. And right then I knew that the moment that we have shared together was a special. That is something. So, Shamey and Joe, I want you to stand up. Again.
Waste of space, man.
Get up. And I want to see you show Jamey. I want to see, we're going to see if you can speak with your hips and if she can translate what you are saying.
So here's your front and center.
Front and center. Because I'm going to ask her. And I want everybody to be quiet. Because many of you know what I am saying when I am passing. Don't give it away. We're going to make Shamey come up and tell us what he says. Okay, we are waiting once again. Once again, we are waiting. Joe, what do you got?
What?
You know what you were saying? Jamie, what did he say to you?
Take me now.
Joe, is that what you meant to communicate? Die. Okay, you know what? I'm done with you, Joe. Sit down.
Apparently, Frederico.
Maybe the joke is on us.
There is no shaming in our gaming, apparently.
That's a good one, honey.
But you know, there are mucho fish in the sea. I think we better be on our way. Go find some.
Before we do that, though, you know, Shamey, I just want to make sure. I want you to tell us. Okay, we're both staring at you, very uncomfortably. Which one of us? Which one, Juan or Federico, do you choose?
Jose.
Jose.
Yeah.
We cannot help everybody, but I can only say one. I am happy for them. And Joey passed the test. He let out his manly cry.
And it was a weak manly cry, but she loved it.
She loved it. And he was able to speak with his heaps. And she understood, okay? I think maybe our work here is done. And I'm glad that, once again, we have not met a woman come between us as I once I thought could be.
Good thing. Good thing.
What do you say we go celebrate the rest of the day? Go fishing together. Well, thank you very much. Wonderful.
Hold on, buddy. Hold on.
Shorter than the blue. I like the way you work.